apparently this is uncomfy.
Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be doing the final book haul of the year. It's not a very big one, it's just that Waterstones did their half price off hardbacks sale. Obviously I had to pick some up, so without further ado, here are the books that I bought to close off 2022. I've got three paperbacks and four hardbacks here. So for the three paperbacks, I have Elle Kennedy's Good Girl Complex. I've heard very, very mixed things about this one. I think people tend to say it's more towards the side than like, I love this book. But you know what? Elle Kennedy is the author of the Briar Ewan Off Campus series. I mean, people love those. So I wanted to see why people then don't like this one. So I think she's like this rich, good girl type. And he's like, I hate rich people, bad boy type. And what else is going to happen apart from they fall in love, obviously. And I just want to see how it plays out, because like I said, it's written by Elle Kennedy. I want to know if it lives up to the hype. So the next book I actually picked up from Sainsbury's because it was £4.50. Honestly, check Sainsbury's and your local like Tesco's for books, because I think Tesco do £2 for £9 and Sainsbury's do £4.50 each book, and you get the new releases for them, because I believe this came out that week in paperback and they already had it on there. And like I said, £4.50, you really can't complain. I wanted to read this when this first came out, but I just couldn't justify it being in hardback form. I absolutely prefer paperbacks, but I will buy a hardback if A, I really want to read the book and the paperback isn't going to be out for a long time, or if it's like a book that I think is so pretty or so, I don't know, significant in a sense that I want it to be in hardback form. And I saw that this is a book that Obama put on his, I think, like favorite reads of 2022. I'm very intrigued to see how they delve into the idea of what women being mothers should be like and how society tells them how to be a good mother. But yeah, I am very excited. This one is a bit of a weird one to get at this time of the year. I really wanted to get this during like Halloween time and I just couldn't find it anywhere. But without dabbling on for too much longer, Tender is the Flesh by Augustina Bastarica. I've heard wild things about this. I wouldn't say it's a thriller, but it's definitely horror in a sense that it's about this man who basically sells human flesh to people, and I don't know anything else about it, which is how I would quite like to keep it. And I think it's quite short. It's 219 pages, quite big font. So I feel like I can binge this in a couple of sittings. I am very intrigued to see what this one's about. Moving on to the four hardbacks. I couldn't think of the name then. Four hardbacks that I picked up from the Waterstones sale. I am so excited to get into this. It is Babel by Arif Kuang. I have wanted to read this already anyway. But then if you are part of a Bookstagram, you might have seen a Bookstagrammer who reviewed this book and she kind of slated it. And unfortunately, her opinions came across, at the very least, quite ignorant. I mean, I'm all for everybody having their own opinions. I'm all for, you know, especially with like literature and any sort of like art in general, it's there to be critiqued essentially, and it's translated differently by each set of eyes, is whatever the experience is each piece. However, the way she was talking about it was very, like I said, I'm just gonna, it's ignorant at the very least. And it really had me actually want to read it more. And I saw so many memes of people being like, Babel supremacy. I am actually going to be doing a buddy read of this with a bunch of girls from Instagram. How many pages is Babel? Babel is 546. So I'm gonna do it. I think having it as a buddy read too would be quite fun. So yeah, Babel. Okay, next up, I have wanted this for so long actually. I just couldn't justify getting it in hardback and I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna wait for paperback. So I thought, whatever, it's, I saw it part of the half price deal. So here I am with a copy of Atessa Moshveg's Lapphoner. I actually have a couple of her books already. I have Death in Her Hands and My Year of Rest and Relaxation. I haven't read them yet. So this is a bit of a risk because I feel like she is either someone you love or hate, but when this first came out, everybody was like, that's a great book. It's a weird one, but it's great. I, for one, love a weird book. And apparently this This is uncomfy. Next, we have Eric LaRocca's Things Have Gotten Worse Since We Last Spoke and Other Misfortunes. Again, I love books that make me feel a bit uncomfy. I DKY. But this is basically a collection of short stories, if I'm not mistaken. But everything seems to be very horror, very weird, very in this book. And I'm actually very intrigued. Like I said, I love intriguing books. And the last hardback that I have for you guys is Olivia Blake's Alone With You In The Ether. I thought I would pick this up because A, it had really great reviews, and B, can we just take a moment to, like, yeah, the dust jacket, perfect, but look at this. This is the exclusive Waterstones edition with the sprayed edges. It is absolutely beautiful. Without the dust jacket, it just still looks very beautiful, and it was half price, so who was I to say no to it? I don't really know too much about it. I don't know if it's like self-development slash romance. Oh, it literally says a love story. So yeah, I'd be very intrigued as to how this is a love story in a sense, but we will find out. So those are all the books that I picked up for the end of 2022. I will be starting a new series on my channel, which is going to be my reading my physical TBR. I'm gonna be doing book by book on both Reels and TikTok. I will link everything down below, and then I'll do like a big video here on YouTube so you can kind of keep up with me that way. But yeah, anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please do give it a thumbs up, and if you haven't yet, please subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.